You are now watching Streetwatchers Radio. The streets is watching.
Hot, super hot fire. Streetwatchers Radio. I got the squad in here. And of course, Miss Pucci. How you doing, Pucci?
Hi.
It's Pucci, not Coochie. Somebody asked me.
You're so extra.
Somebody asked me, you got Miss Coochie up there? I was like, who?
No, they definitely did not.
All right, maybe not. But
they might call up, right?
Yeah, they could call up 1-877-760-1422. Nigga, you see, I didn't even look, nigga.
What's up?
You squad, nigga. You squad. Squad.
Can I remember the number?
You want to start this early? Let's not start this early. I got the squad in here. Let me let them introduce themselves one by one. First, Pucci, why don't you introduce yourself so we have a formal introduction. One more time.
Hi, everyone. It's Miss Pucci, M-I-S-S underscore P. U-C-C-I underscore. Big, just for anybody that has any misconception.
Yeah, yeah. Big P.
You know what I'm saying?
All right.
My turn? Oh, God. Nah, it's my team, but you know what it is. Queens, what's up?
Yo, what up? It's your man Sean Diddy. What's good, Queens?
Extra light skin, like.
Yo, it's Young Nino.
Yo, wait, why y'all laughing? Hold on.
Wesley.
Young Nino.
AKA.
AKA the Black Dundada. AKA the Black Plague.
Okay.
AKA the Real Chance.
The Black Plague.
The Black Plague. I spread across everywhere.
Okay.
Oh, that's serious when it was out. The bubonic plague was crazy.
Okay.
So, we also got a special guest himself.
Come through, Chuck. Stunning in the building, what's up?
What
made me live tonight? Drop that.
How did he get the bomb and I don't get the bomb? None of us.
Because I'm the bomb, baby. I'm here supporting my bros, man. Doing real big things.
You already know what it is.
Got Southside on lock.
Here it goes.
Oh, shit. I ain't gonna do it.
As you can see, it's a squad in here. I got Mike Chambers, Sean Diddy, the Real Chance, aka the Real Plague. Chuck, Stunner Chuck in the building, and Miss Pucci, let's get it correct. Alright, why don't we just start off, because I know D-Money's on his way. So why don't we just get the room hot already? It's already like mad niggas, so it feels like...
It's already hot.
I mean, you're going to be burning yourself.
I'll pour something for that.
Uh-oh. Oh, God. For yourself?
Yeah. Alright, cool. Oh, y'all want it? Nah, y'all ain't get one. Alright, check this out. Let's talk. Pucci, can I start with you?
Sure,
why not? Why don't you give us a little background on why you started stripping?
I'm gonna take it back to when I first started, which was I started doing parties with all my friends, you know, and we known as the Moet Ladies. So, you know, we took it pretty far young, you know what I mean? We started doing parties, modeling, music. And then from there, you know, I started doing makeup, hosting parties, bartending, bottle service.
Okay.
So I like, you know, dipping in pot a couple
don't
different places.
In, it's a bunch of
oh, here we go.
I'm immature as fuck.
Immature. Y'all are so funny.
Chandler, same question for you. Well, how did it get started for you?
Yeah, everything about this thing changes after
it's a movie, you know what I mean? It's a movie. Nah, I started in my backyard. Couple years ago, like 2-3 years ago, I guess.
Nah, you're gonna have to stop the mace talk. I need you to speak.
You trying to be smooth.
I'm just saying,
you gotta be smooth, man. That's the trail speed ride. You gotta be smooth.
Nah, I started in my backyard. Made a couple beds from the backyard, flipped it, went to Mink, flipped that, and I'm here where I'm at.
So that means you still have the bands from the backyard?
Yeah, I save every penny, man.
Diddy, what's up, man? P Rock?
Yeah, man, we started doing team parties like in, Chance 07? Something like that. We started doing team parties and just worked our way up. And now we're still running shit. Sorry for the rest of the people. You can't say that.
He be letting us go! This is why he came here. He came here to work. You know what I mean?
Oh, man. I've just been around for a minute. I've played basketball.
fucking, what else I did, man? Host parties, do basketball tournaments. Recently had a little DJ battle. Shout out to Ernie B.
He won.
He was just sponsored. I'll be everywhere, man. Everybody know me. You know what I'm saying?
Fuji. Castle. The game is crazy the way the game is.
How you figure?
The way the game itself is, there's a lot of people. First of all, let me start by saying tonight we have with me lane.
Oh, don't forget.
Anybody who could beat me tonight is not getting nothing. I'm not getting nothing.
I got my money on chance.
Thank you.
I got my money on chance. Okay. Got $100 on chance.
I'm not putting $100 on you, crazy.
See, you scared.
I'm not scared.
You
too crazy.
You know.
Anybody you got.
Yo.
Literally, anybody you got, literally.
You know what? We're gonna put another wager on that.
Well, nah, I gotta ring it. Literally anybody you got.
Nah, let's get to the point here.
All right, get to the point.
Let me start by you. Do you think the game, party promoting itself, is the game coming from you started with Moet Ladies? Now, Moet Ladies is like, what is the M-O-E-T mean?
It stands for money over everything.
Oh. Now, I know Moet Ladies, they was known. Mm-hmm. There was a lot of rumors.
A lot of rumors,
what's
the rumor, though?
Now, but hey, I'm here to do my job,
you here to do your
job. Oh, so basically you want to address the rumors. My job is to ask you, what's the craziest rumor you heard that was circulating about Moet Ladies? Don't tell me you never heard a rumor.
I don't really hear rumors. I only want to say no rumors because usually it's truth. I mean, hopefully if it's not something negative that's crazy, like, you know, I'm saying, if you heard something, please enlighten me.
Oh, no, we get to that.
Enlighten us all.
We get to that.
I would love to know.
Listen, I just want to throw salt everywhere. This is what I'm here to do. I'm here to throw salt everywhere, then y'all get open about it, and then we talk. You feel me? You feel me? Chat, like, I'm stunned, niggas. Stone Cold Steve Austin and this motherfucker.
And you get right into it.
Now, how do you think the game itself, the state it is right now?
The club game? The promotion game?
She shook her head.
Okay. I think that a lot of, and this is not to nobody in this room, mm-hmm. but I think that a lot of promoters put a lot of their faith into their employees. I'm going to say employees.
You see, when Cass, can you play that again? Let me give you guys a little. A key. When they taught you the mat and they were like the key. When this comes on, that's when you get to rant. You get to go off.
Oh, okay.
Talk your shit.
Oh, okay. So basically, yeah, I feel like a lot of these promoters right now, they put too much on our backs. And I'm going to say our because I promote, but I also bartend and I also bottle host. So I feel like, you know, a lot of them are not carrying their weight. They not. They wait and they want us to bring 50 niggas, bust up 4 bands out of register. And don't get me wrong, yeah, a couple nights out of the week you will get some men that will do that, but let's keep it funky. The average nigga is not spending 4 bands every night.
He don't got it to do that.
Mm. So, you know, let's just be realistic. If you're gonna throw a venue, you gotta be creative.
Yeah, let's name a couple of these people that you done promote for that was good business.
Well, I'm going to say Sanchez the Great. Shout out to Sanchez the Great. Biz Baby. DJ West. You know what I'm saying? Definitely him.
Well, you was at a car wash today. Who was throwing that car wash today?
The owners, actually.
Oh, the owners?
One of the owners contacted me for the car wash. It's on 91st Street and 101 Avenue.
Now, would you tell people go to wash their car there?
I mean, yeah, they have good service, but you know, I mean, we had a little discrepancy on
He wanted you to get naked?
No, he didn't want me to get naked. Stop, cut the shenanigans. Okay?
Hey, that's my job.
He wanted me to get extra wet. Pause.
Oh, God.
Shit.
Once they pause, okay? Because y'all got filthy minds.
Yeah.
Filthy.
Yo, Chance said
he
it.
He wanted me to get,
yeah, I don't know.
You know, a little bit.
Came
so I had to, you know, just let him know. Like, I have other things that I do with my day. I'm not going to sit here and just be so pouring tons of water on myself.
So that was like, a regular party promoter who wants you to do extra.
Well, he wasn't a promoter.
Then, I'm just saying, we're going to just, like.
Oh, like if we was taking it there.
Yeah, there
are some promoters that just want you to go that extra mile.
What's
like, I'm not sacrificing my morals.
What's the craziest thing a promoter asks you
Let a nigga bag me, take me to breakfast, and, you know, talk to him so the nigga will come back and spend some more money.
Wow, that promoter must have...
He was very bold to ask me that, but I'm just saying, they are, you know, and I can say for myself, I know I have morals. I know what I will do and what I won't do.
So,
some females...
So what promoter wouldn't you work with again?
Put him on blast.
Nah, we don't play it.
Everybody I worked with, I pretty much.
Let me tell you guys something from beginning. It's hey, spring. When you guys come up here, we don't play that little kid shit. You see, the thing is, I brought these two back. Let me tell you something, Pucci. I brought these two back because they came here thinking shit was sweet last time.
I had my leather jacket.
Nah, niggas was on something. I was like, yo, tell me name. They was like, nah, the nigga let her start with it. Nah, I won't even see you. We're not here to do that. Today we're not here to do that. Today we're here to talk. It's called a discussion. Now, every month I think me and Cass is going to do something like this, right, Cass? We bring a group of people that connects in some way. I mean, we talk. So we talk, so what the camera's on. You know what I mean? This is part of the job.
It's on the internet. It's on the internet.
They hear it. They hear it. You get what I'm saying? So there's people that you don't want to work with. Let's start off with somebody better.
Yeah.
Let's start off. Like Diddy. There's niggas that you wouldn't work with, right?
Yeah, a lot.
Like who?
The business I won't work with. Wouldn't work with Japan. We'll work with a lot of people for what? It makes no sense. Because if I'm gonna sit there and work with you, and I'm gonna be bringing out everybody, that's not fair to me. And you, and they gonna be eating too.
I'm saying,
what? I don't know y'all talking about.
From my recollections, from the numbers, the scoreboard is looked like the business was winning. They had
winning what?
They did a lower, I think, like last year, I think, and I heard it was some off.
Listen, all right, so let me ask you a question. What happened to the last party?
I didn't know.
Okay. Listen. Let me tell you something. Listen. If you sit there and you out there promoting yourself like you are the shit, that you feel like you shouldn't work with a lot of other people, then every time you have a party, you better pop.
When I come in your party,
and you say it's popping in there, I don't want to be there and it's the bartenders and the security, and that's it. Because then you suck.
It sound like you went to one recently.
Yo, drop a bomb.
It sound like you went to a couple recently.
I see.
What about when they bring an artist out and you still suck? Oh, an artist.
Then you really suck.
Damn.
Then you really suck. You bring an artist out, and you promoting, and yo, this person's gonna be here, and you still flop, then you suck. You don't deserve to be a party promoter anymore. You deserve to work at Kiefer. You know what I'm saying?
He ain't say what's the name. Looking at the
end. And that's how it goes. That's how it goes.
Getting no bricks.
That's it.
He's in his bag.
Chance, do you feel the same way?
Listen, everybody has a slow night. Everybody has a down.
Yo, do not come here.
No, being real.
I even keep it real.
Even with the DJ battle, it wasn't the best we wanted to be.
Uh-huh.
You know, it was on Mother's Day. A lot of DJs flopped out, aka scared out.
Mm-hmm.
It was a lot of. It wasn't what we wanted it to be.
DJs flopped out.
Oh shit, man.
Just name the DJ that didn't.
I have him.
No. DJ Busy, know. DJ School.
Busy came though.
What I'm saying is, it's not like I'm not saying they were scared. They let me know ahead of time, but there were some DJs I can't remember offhand that didn't even say anything and just didn't even show up. Now, regardless of the fact that night was slow, and like you said, if you good as your last name, then we a flop.
I don't think that.
In my eyes.
You see, I don't think what Diddy said is like directly true because. Pucci, if I'm correct, there's people that do it weekly, and their weeklies be killing every weekend. You know, they have a slow night.
It happens. And the weekly is different like that, though.
I mean, excuse me. I personally feel like this. If every week you throw in the same type of party, what type of results do you think you're going to get? Every week. Every week is the strip club venue. Every week is the... I mean, I'm not even going to say socials or lounges because those are catered to relax, you know, come and chill and relax. I'm going to say, like, when a lot of promoters are throwing these parties, they don't want to think out the box. They don't want to take it back to old school promoting, printing up flyers, street teams.
Getting on the streets.
They don't want to. They don't want to put in no work. They want to do Instagram promoting.
That's
look, see, I'm glad you said that. That's exactly what we was talking about the last time I was here. That's when they get cocky and they get comfortable. They feel they pack out a party, and you know what? I don't need to do it. I just go on Instagram and.
But it's because of niggas like Chambers. Chambers is giving these niggas a range.
He's different. He got braids. He's special.
You know, you said Latrell Smooth, but let's remember Latrell Smooth won't choke out his own coach. So, I don't think there's nothing smooth about Latrell Smooth.
Let's try to be smooth today.
Chambers, how do you feel about people who feel like you done came up and now you being proud of them?
Me being proud of?
Yeah.
Me personally?
Yeah.
I don't think I'm proud of. I'm more like, you know, Balenciaga.
You're probably pretty played out, so if you still thinking. But you get what I'm trying to say.
Nah, I'm playing.
You know
playing,
what I mean? How do you think about people feeling like, you know, oh, he thinks he's too better than that? What do you say to them?
Honestly, I don't. So. Therefore, they probably frightened. I don't know, but I'm chill for the most part. I do business with not everybody, but I do business with a lot of people.
So you wouldn't do business with everybody, but who?
But now
who wouldn't you
now because with? He gave me another perspective of thinking. He told me that, well, Diddy told me that I'm too accessible to people.
Okay.
So now I'm closing my doors to a lot.
Like, who are you closing your door to that you would normally probably take a check from?
Stop.
I'm not gonna burn my bridges and shoot at everybody that I'm
I burn every you. Bridge.
It's not this
because I'm strong.
It's I not burn. About listen, me and Diddy talked about this. It's not about burning bridges, because at the end of the day, if that bridge burned, unless there's a puddle, unless it's a fucking river between one part and another, you can always walk around. You can always build your own bridge, nigga.
They tell me that. No, they say that. They say, yo, listen, you gotta chill out. You burning your bridges. But I said, how am I burning a bridge if I never needed them in the first place?
You don't care about these.
I don't know. I don't care.
Chance, you and Chambers, this is a good. You get what
you gotta have him on the squad,
though. Chuck, is there people that you wouldn't work with?
Let me talk right now. Diddy right now is on his light skin shit.
No,
right
it's
now.
Not that. It's just being.
Well, look. Let me tell you what's different about the difference about Diddy and the people you're talking about. Diddy got a strong team behind him that Chance is gonna go that humble route while Diddy talk that shit. Combine that together, we taking over each block.
Okay. Everybody has their own set that you bring together.
You know what I mean? We have our characters in the group.
It's a dip set thing.
It's a dip set thing.
The dip set was hot. Now right. Jewels is right.
But now we're on some genius shit.
I'm from Southside. I don't know about that dip set shit.
Oh, so you Southside too?
I'm from Southside. I don't know about that dip set.
No, this is genius.
I'm originally from
Olivia. This is genius. No, it's going to be genius. This is how we're going to do it.
She's not a good thing.
So what? She's still, no, we junior when it first came out.
The summer was old.
Yeah, good.
I'm about to come back though. I ain't gonna hold y'all. I got some ends on that.
Here you go. Mr.
Connect. That's Mr. Connect right there.
I'm the plug.
You're the plug. Now, Pooch, let's take it to a different light. What do you feel about people that say bottle service, bottle girls fucked up the game? Because I'm not going to lie to you, I think that personally.
I'm going to put it to you like this. When men come to the strip club, I'm going to take it to the strip club. I'm not even going to put it in the regular club. Right?
You're cheating at the strip club already.
All right. It's not really cheating, though.
Yes, it is.
Because if I got the niggas...
Your ass is out already.
This is, no. Hold on. Let's keep it 100, though. If I got the niggas that's coming now spending the money, how you complaining? Because you ain't bring them here. I brought them here. I called on that phone and said, yo, listen, come out tonight to such and such spot. It's me and my homegirls on this bar, on that bar. Come fuck up some commas. And then they come through, like, oh, look.
It's a business phone call.
Is she really picking up a FaceTime right now?
Yeah, I am, because I gotta let one of the ladies know. I got Maya on the line right here. Yo, I'm on the radio right here. So everybody's... Say what up to Maya.
Yo, what up, Maya?
I told
you to hit my
phone.
What's up, Maya?
Oh, all right, but, like, yeah, you know, but that's like, you know, everything. My bad, boo. I'm going to clear it back.
That's real professional.
I had to. But now I'm dead ass. Like, you know, at the end of the day, like I said, I've been doing this a long time. So if I call my homeboys up and tell them to come to the club tonight, but I'm going to make sure they show them love too. Mm-hmm. But if they come in and they going to cop bottles from me, that how is that stopping your money?
You said the way
I ask you a question?
How?
I'm sorry.
Yo.
Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
Are you getting paid at the door by these people that's coming in?
There's a booking fee.
No, but you know what? I'm not getting paid by them at the door, no. But I'm getting paid by making sure that they're compensating me, with whether it's so putting a couple hundred in my hand or what, whatever.
They can't buy bottles unless they come in them doors.
Okay. So, but honestly speaking, I'm not the promoter for
but
the
strip clubs,
night.
Right.
The promoter booked me.
That's why. That's
strip clubs are different because you can run shit.
That's why bottle girls, bottle server girls, and bartenders. That's the separation between them and promoters. You're not promoted. If you're gonna promote, you should get paid as a promoter.
No. But that's what I'm trying to say. If it's my party that I'm promoting and I'm getting bar money and I'm getting whatever other money that comes in the building, if it's my party,
it's your party.
But if it's not my party and somebody else books me to do their party, then I'm getting compensated on the people that are coming for me to
also,
your party.
Also you're booking right.
I'm not losing no money because everybody's not coming for me. That's where they get the concept of let's get five or six different girls because each different girl is gonna bring a different set of niggas. If I'm from Queens and I know niggas from Queens and Long Island, that's who's gonna come for me. If Shorty's from Brooklyn, another girl from Yonkers, another girl from Dykeman, you see what I'm saying? We're gonna have niggas from everywhere
hood,
that's
like,
getting that's coming to spend money. They're not gonna come there if every single, you know, and some people do this, they book girls that are from the same area for every party, and then you expect the result, like, what's the different results? Because the same niggas, and I'm not knocking nobody how you get your money or whatever. If whether you moving Wayne, you fucking scamming, you doing whatever out here getting your money, but every venue is not gonna be like that.
Money
you can't expect to get into the city parties and keep getting booked if those are the type of crowds you're bringing, because they don't want to deal with that
at all. Preach. You know what? Let's take a music break. When we come back,
I like this.
When we come back, we're gonna turn it up a little bit. I'ma ask Chance, you know what I mean, to tell me all the joints he done been sleeping with that's his career so far.
Gotta give up two, bro.
Why we gotta go back there?
What? We're trying to go in a circle.
Yeah, man.
I mean, like, let's do it right, man.
Ask me out of that.
Nah, you stay right here, Paul. You ain't going nowhere. Streetwatchers Radio, DJ Castle, what's up? I even got Pucci talking about you bum ass Barbies.
I never said the Barbies at all.
Hollywood Chuck, not Hollywood Butters, because I'm from Butters, so
that's how it's all.
We got somebody on the phone. He couldn't make it was kind of far, but what's up?
Yo, what's up?
Yo, D Money himself, formerly from We All In. Correct? Yo, D, what's up with you?
That nigga got me a boondock. I gave me an address. I put it in my GPS. And I'm way out here in the boondock. I'm trying to take it down right now. But what's up, though? Like, what's good? What's going on up there?
Nah, we just talking promotion itself. Like, the game is, you know, Diddy was over here telling me the people he don't like. He was telling me he don't think he would never do business with the business or Japan Cream. He was just shooting names. What kind of people would you not do business with, D?
Who would I not do business with in the game right now?
Yeah.
I mean, I can't do business with everybody because they're
Don't give me that politically correct answer, bro.
Don't let him go.
Niggas know, look, niggas know we not playing, so come to me and you. Everybody know we straight money, we not playing, you know, it's cool, like, but a couple of niggas I probably won't do.
Now, why are we...
Go back. You heard him?
Yeah,
he put Japan Cream on.
He put him on. Now, Now, why are we saying formerly We All In when you was the face of We All In?
Well, see what happened with that situation. There's a little street shit that happened. I wasn't in nobody's business in the street too crazy, but it was a street situation that went wrong. And, you know, we decided to part ways. There's no bad blood or anything like that. There's still my brothers over there, but, you know, so just so we could be clear, like, before I make you my enemy, I'd rather sever all ties. Like, you know what I'm saying? So we can still be family. We don't have to do business together. You get what I mean?
Nah, I get you totally. Now, I remember there was a little, you know what? Let's give him a little sneak peek of when D-Money does come up here. Now, you, back in the days, you was considered a bully in the game.
Yeah.
You're still a bully now in some way? Because, you know, because you're the Shug Knight of promotions, I would say. You know what I'm saying? When D-Money comes up to you like, yo, get managed by CEO management, you look at him like, boy, my life on that paper? I don't know. Now, you have a lot of people you're managing and you're doing very well for them. Now, let me drop a name. You're managing Ruxpin, correct?
Really?
Ruxpin.
When did that happen, bro?
I ain't going to phone call about that.
Yeah.
I didn't get the email.
He's burning a lot of bridges in these streets, bro.
I feel like I got light over the years.
Now, D,
we just got used to him.
Now, D, let's get into a little gossip news with the whole D Money. Now, you've been in the game being the Shug Knight of the game and all that, so you done sliced a couple things. Back in the days when there was a lot of female promoting teams, I know you had numbers, because, you know, we was going back and forth. Who was the worst one?
There was a couple of teams out there that was good. Like.
Now, who was the worst one that who was the worst one that you slayed?
The worst team I think from a female promotional team?
Yeah.
I don't think I can do her like that.
Yo, cut it out, bro.
Don't do it, D.
Tell us the team name.
Alright, just tell us the team name.
Wave
was there on the line, too.
Wave. Get the wave under the bus.
My nigga, Wave. You have to catch a dancing segment.
If I see your team, then you're going to know the girl.
Nah, just say the team, bro. It's like, come on. We grown.
That's the wrong to catch a nigga.
Damn, man, it's going to be too hot.
Your whole world gets late.
Shout out to, I can't remember, bro.
You're great at this. I see. Yo, you're great at this lying game.
You trying to fuck up my
Oh, so you still slaying it? That's what you're saying.
Yeah,
was it a Starbucks number?
I'm not slaying it, but you're listening. What? Next question.
Yo, I'm gonna let you drive, bro. We gonna have you up here officially. I know you're going to a day party, correct?
Correct. I'm about to go to the day party right now. My BTR niggas been doing a lot, but
all right, you call us if it's whack. You let us know if it's whack, cause Diddy's looking to point out niggas who's whack right now.
Well, hold on, who's whack? Let me know who's whack in the game right now, cause a lot of niggas is whack.
Who's whack in the game to you, bro?
Who whack in the game to me?
Yeah. Nah,
I told myself I want to do business with the business.
I said, I want to do business with Japan Korean because they like to pocket money, you know?
Right.
So, I mean, who else you got?
Who Chambers play?
Yo, Chambers is trying to
Chambers is cool.
Yo, he's trying to be mace right now. You know, Chambers and Chance, they over here like, nah, we
can't. Hey, yo, Shug, tell them who you don't like, man. Nah, I never heard of him.
I know who you're talking about.
It's a little nigga. He was on Instagram like maybe 2 or 3 weeks ago. He was playing with wrestling. And
he's playing with him?
He had something out of law. I had to jump on the road. It was like, you know, I don't play with kids. I don't play with kids. And he gave me a DM like, bro, I'm sorry.
Now, I heard about that situation, but once again, you're doing guidance counselors for little kids.
Yeah, you're a guidance counselor, dude. They look up to you,
you're
man.
You're going to be put into these situations, bro. Let's talk about people that's on our level.
What I'm saying.
Thank you.
Let's
thank
talk about
you,
people
you.
On our level.
Thank
all
you.
The
trying to get
people
bigger,
do not,
not
matter.
Not small.
There's nobody else on our level, though.
No, they matter.
Who?
Like, but they got to learn, though, because, you know, everybody's on Instagram what the new thing is, but they know Instagram right now. They take the certain picture of the angle of the party and put it up like I had a solo.
You know what?
It's angles to this shit.
Like, yes,
I just don't post my shit. But that ain't happening in a while. So.
Now. Now we got the sexy Miss Pucci here. Now, what do you think about bottle service women, like, and just doing that whole thing? Period.
I think they're very miscellaneous. I think most bottle girls don't really bring nothing to the table. They just get to get money.
Yeah.
But it's a part of the game. You know what I'm saying? The club owners, they adapted that situation because I remember when a nigga used your fucking bottles came with the Mexican breaking bottles.
360.
What's your own facts, bottles, nigga? What? I remember we used to carry our own bottles and put it on the floor. That's a fact.
Yeah, well, yeah, that's Jamaican style all the way. You feel
put
me?
Put a couple ice roll right now. Good.
We thought it's nice. You're going to get down with buckets on the floor. You feel what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I think they were miscellaneous. I think some of them were sexy. I think a lot of them got ass shot. and a lot of them too, like you take that makeup off, bitch is ugly. And they can go, bitch, where?
She said, bitch, where?
Bitch, well, wear. I wear lots of makeup and I can take it off and still look good. So, I'm not one of those. No.
Is your light skin, right?
Yeah. Yes, it is.
So it wasn't directed towards you.
But,
I think you're beautiful.
Thank you.
You're a bottle girl?
I bartend, I do makeup, I do it all.
I'm right, I want to see you with no makeup on too because I mean I like makeup, don't get me wrong, but I think with makeup makes you look 100% better, and that means you're a fucking negative 100% wet boy. I mean, yeah, so I mean, but you know what, a lot of girls don't, a lot of girls, especially, you know, we're gonna take it to the Instagram, a lot of girls won't post a picture with no makeup on. I do that very often, and I know why, because I'm saying this, man. You know what I mean? Fucking 500 days out the year, and I say 500,
yeah,
it's only
300.
Fucking
366.
Like, what
are we?
I'm dating a female or I'm dating a zombie?
Oh shit, niggas,
I'm dating
a female
or a zombie. We're gonna take it back to the fact that a lot of maybe not, you know, you obviously not y'all as the promoters, but the club owners want a certain type of look. They don't want girls coming in there. If you're right, if a bitch needs makeup to really look good all the time, then that's a sad thing for her. I feel bad. But a lot of them do want that extra polished look. You know, they don't want you coming looking like you going to the gym. They want you coming looking like, you know, a little sexy. They want you to look good.
But listen, if you look like you're in a casket, though,
yeah, but then that's where they need to come see me so I can make sure I beat their face and they're not looking like that.
Okay, what's your Instagram? So they can hit you up.
It's Miss Pucci, MISS_PUCCI _.
MISSIPPY.
You're funny.
Nah, but listen, I understand that. I like bottle girls, but like I said, sometimes it's
No, I feel you. We were talking about this before, you know, we spoke to you, and it has a lot to do with the fact if they're not bringing anything to the table. But then again, a lot of promoters only count on them. So if you're not that type of promoter, then you're good. Then that's just an addition. It's not, you know, what you're holding your party. Oh, my party's going to pop because I got Linda Rose. My party's going to pop because I got Winnie or Panda or even with me. You're not going to count on just the fact that you got me or any other bottle girl or bartender or host or whatever you want to call it. You're going to count on the fact that you are a good promoter.
Yo, D.
But that's my thing is, when a bottle girl starts
Yo, D, listen.
I got something for that.
Like at the end of the day, if I'm making money and my bar's doing great and I'm looking at my bar and say 20 grand, but after they take taxes out and then they take the bar and the shit out and they do all that and I'm down to 15 grand and these bitches want to own $700 each and all they did was play some scandalous shit.
Yeah, but at the end of the day too, hold on, like this, like I said earlier, if my homeboy is the one that's coming out spending $5,000, then I'm entitled to that $700.
Yeah, you should be compensated.
I should be compensated wholeheartedly, 100%.
But he's talking about the girls that don't.
But if you're a girl, no, I do, and that's why I said I understand what you're saying, because I go through this a lot. I go through this as well as other girls. When we bring guys that spending money, and then there's girls that don't bring nobody. And it don't matter if he spent $100 or if he spent $1,000. If that's my customer, as long as he's coming through the door and he's supporting the club, y'all and me, then we're all
but
good.
A lot of people don't like to buy bottles and then pay at the door. So it's like...
But that's I feel like that's another thing. But hold on. I feel like that's another thing, though. Because if you go to the city, bottle service is bottle service. You walk in through the door. Yeah. It's not... You shouldn't have to pay to get in if you want bottle service.
It's all about the deal that you have at the end of the day with the club and the promoter. So...
I mean, you know, that's what I'm saying. It's like, it goes half-half. If he's coming and he's like, yo, I'm going to buy 7 bottles.
I ain't go front. Like,
you want to still charge him at the door?
When I start doing, when I'm doing this shit now, I'm about to start taxing these bottle girls because I know I bring a lot of money to this bar. Mm-hmm. So, if I'm working,
the case, then we're going to take it there, then you need to do a contract. You need to have your girls that's working exclusively for you and do a contract. That's how you gotta do it, because I know for me, if I'm bringing my peoples, I don't give a fuck.
I think bottle girls should start tipping in and tipping out.
Nah, I'm definitely not throwing that. Strippers pay to work tonight. Yo, D, we gotta hang up the phone.
And keep the phone lines open for anybody else calling.
You said I gotta get on the phone?
Bring that ass here, boy.
Oh, here, take this.
Nah, yo, D, I gotta leave the phone lines open for anybody else calling. We're gonna have you up here personally, and we're gonna talk everything.
Yo, I'm up here too.
I don't want to hear these niggas no more talking about they doing it, they doing that. That nigga got some money. Y'all see me. I run shit, and the niggas with me, they run the shit too. But as a family, we got this shit on lock. And we just let, if we let that nigga eat, I want niggas to know that. Like, if we want to be like, yo, y'all get some plus, I will book every club and just give it to other niggas. Like, everybody be careful about what they say. It's going to be a hot summer. I want to say RP the cheap straw. This is a no lacking summer. We're not lacking this summer. You feel me? So all my niggas up there, that means that they party Chamber City, Chan.
We at the bowling alley after, though.
Much love, man.
Oh, yo, no, you know I'm going to go to that shit, the bowling alley, too. You know I'm going to go there and bust the strike. You know, that's all I do. But you know how I go. That nigga's hollering at me, though, and I'll thank you. I'll be up there another day. And life's good.
I think he won't part.
This nigga D is crazy.
Yo, D.
Nah.
Yo, D, go ahead. We're gonna holler at you, boy. You be safe.
I'll holler at you.
Yeah.
Yo, nigga D crazy.
Yo, it is It is. Yo, what's
your homeboy slang?
Yo. Okay, that's
no.
Okay, that's.
No, that's good.
That's good.
This shit is terrible.
I gave up my seat. I normally don't do this. I normally never give up my seat, but you know, my man Chuck was standing, so we gave up the seat to Chuck. Now, it's crazy what's going on here. Diddy, can you pass that mic to that man right here? The one next to you. It's crazy what's going on here. Now, Chance, you were,
Chuck.
You were definitely, I consider you from my era. You get what I'm saying? You with the Guess Who, Different World type of era. You get what I'm saying? Now, that era alone was wild to be a dark skinned nigga. Because, you know, we had to fight.
Me and Paul Diddy.
We had to fight our way into the, you know what I mean? Mm. Into the pussy, literally. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So, now, was it easy for you to be around that crowd already?
It was easy because I was the only one.
Okay.
Out of all my friends, so out of like everybody, they was the, yeah, I was the fake, the hood exotic.
Okay. So you took a couple things down.
Exotic. I took a lot of things down.
Now you look like the type thing, I mean, be good, no kiss and tell, I understand, I respect it. But every man has his day. Every female done burn a bridge. And you know, this once or twice you can say something. You know, like,
nah, I go for every girl that there's not one girl that I ever touched or talked to that I can't text right now and say, what's up, let's get a drink. So it's not, I never left a girl on a bad blood, ever.
So that means when you ate it out, it was good.
Wait. Huh? When did I say all that?
I'm just saying.
I mean, it's a part of the wave, but nah, I didn't eat everybody out. Hey, you trying to stop me out.
Look,
now everybody look at me with the eyed ass face now. They're gonna start moving their cups away from me and shit.
Oh, Chuck asked a good question.
I'm dark skinned at the end of the day.
So you do eat ass?
I don't eat ass, like it's not a practice, like I don't come in the crib and say spread them. But it's a part of the way. You get what I'm saying?
Oh, so you there's no limit to sex.
It depends on who it is.
Okay.
It depends on who it is.
Chambers, what's up? Are you
He's Jamaican. He don't do that shit.
Yo, I don't believe that shit. I went to Hillcrest. So all these Jamaican niggas that was saying I don't eat comp, me don't eat no food.
They ain't real then. They ain't real.
That was like, I'm telling you. It's real.
Nobody know my please. Okay.
Now, Pooch, is that something that if a guy don't do that, he's not getting
what?
What do you think about that?
I mean, this is a crazy, crazy, crazy subject right here. Y'all gonna have me getting something.
Oh, so there's a relationship going on.
Yeah, definitely.
How many years strong?
We almost gonna make 2 years soon.
And you haven't cheated
after that?
No.
Do we eat ass?
What?
Where are we
coming from?
They
gotta get you.
I'm saying, no. Is he grocery
shopping? I'm not into all of that crazy stuff. That's too much for me.
So you laid it flat?
No, I didn't say that. I just said I don't. That doesn't do it for me. That's what we're gonna say. That I don't like that. That's not my thing.
She don't go shopping.
If he tried it, would you let him? If he tried it. That's that face. That pause right there tells it all.
So let it tell. You're trying to get me assassinated. Oh, whoa.
There you go right there.
There you go right there.
Jack's fucking to my real chambers.
Streetwatchers Radio, you're live on YakRadio.com. Who's this? Where you calling from? They hung up? Yo, don't be scared and call and hang up, man. Let's not be scared.
We got your name. Call the ID.
Yo. Chuck just asked a good question. Uh-huh. And when he asked that question, she looked at Chance like.
No, get out of here. Stop trying to get me fucked up when I leave here. Okay. Cut it out.
He's gonna pop me on.
But you know, it's everybody likes what they like. See, stay on. It's no judgment.
But you didn't say you wouldn't accept it.
What if my man tried something like that? I mean, I don't know. I mean, never say never. We gonna say
never.
No, you know what it is with me. I don't feel the need to cheat. If I start feeling like that, then I'd rather leave.
Okay.
You know, I don't want nobody to cheat on me. I before him, I had a very long relationship. I was with somebody who was like a decade.
So when you was in My White Girls, you was in a relationship.
Yeah,
now, how does that work? You a female promoter, bringing niggas out to your party. Like, us as niggas, when we promote and we bring females out to the party, there's one or two or three we're looking at like,
I mean, let's just be real. It's human nature to look and be attracted.
It's
and
the image.
Flirt. That's fine, but know the limitations. If you're in a relationship and you respect your significant other, and I'm going to say significant other, some people is, you know, then you gotta know the boundaries. Like, okay, you're at the party, we laughing, we having a couple drinks, that's it. No, at 3 and 4 in the morning, why is that a person texting your phone? That's unacceptable. Okay. If we leave in the club and it's like, yo, let me get your link, because so next week I want you to come work. Or, yo, next week I want you to come to my party. That's cool. But if it's like, yo, what you doing? Come on.
So you be dubbing a lot of niggas.
Yeah.
Sometimes you gotta entertain that.
You gotta decipher how far you wanna take it. And the person you're dealing with gotta understand that it's a business too. So if I'm a guy and I got a girl, you gotta understand, I gotta flirt with some of these girls, because these are the girls that's gonna come out for me.
That's a good point.
The girls that come out for me.
Girls and guys, is that when you're with someone, a man still wants you.
Always.
No, that's
girls is different.
But the competition is different. So a man want to show me why he wants to take me from my man.
Yeah.
But versus a girl. No. Not as much as us.
Girls be walking up to like, yo, how's your that girl going?
Not as much,
though.
I'm just saying. You got girls that's buying your car? You got girls that's fucking paying your rent? Busting up 4, 5, 6, 7 racks?
Yes, they're scammers.
I'm talking about cash.
I don't accept it all,
because the rules were about cash.
Scammer-wise.
It's 2 for 3.
Scammer-wise. I come outside and bust
it up. If I had somebody that I had to, you know, do I have to flirt? And yeah, but you know, understandably, it's all about respect. You could do that inside of the dwelling of your job, and when you leave there, my phone is off, though.
Chance, you 2 for 3. Like, who bought you a car?
What the fuck?
Oh.
Next.
Wait, what the hell did I say that?
Yeah.
Oh.
This is yo.
You got chick buying you car?
Oh. Why did I say that?
I'm saying, is that ever happened for you?
Listen, man.
No. Whenever a nigga answer, listen, man.
None of that never happened. Okay. I've gotten gifts and stuff like that.
We all get gifts and stuff like that.
You know, I buy a girl things.
What kind of gifts have you got?
No, you got.
You can't even look this way.
Yo,
what's the funny nigga?
Hey, yo, listen, man.
Yo, Diddy, you quiet over there. You know what, Chance? I'm gonna give you some time to think with it.
It's a little hot. Play oil.
Then you got a wife and kids at home. Nah, Diddy. You're a light skinned nigga.
Yep.
I mean, so like
sunblock 14.
It's easy for you in the game.
Nah.
You lick your lips, you do your Omarion face, or you.
Nah, not really. So, they said dark skin niggas is winning, so.
Nah, we've been winning. That's not the point. The point is.
Listen.
Here's the point. Here's what we're talking about.
Yeah.
Now, you dancing all over your gram.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? You throwing kissy signs on other girls' pages.
Oh, shit.
Nah.
Got him. Oh, shit.
Somebody guys at this party.
Maybe that might be not true, but you know, my job is to catch you slipping.
Nah, you know what? I don't like the whole Instagram thing and all that. Like, when you send comments and all that, the kissy faces and all that.
So you're a DMer?
Nah, that's how you get exposed, number one. But nah, I don't do none of that, man. It's like, listen, how can I say it?
I heard a rumor about you.
What's your?
Nah. Give me that again.
I have rumors on everybody in here. I did my homework.
Okay, what room did you hear?
So I'm gonna go around and take it. Trust
okay,
me.
So start with me. What room did you hear?
I heard a rumor about you. We're trying to keep it as one and big. Now, I heard that a certain female was so interested in you, and you know what I mean. She wanted nut on her face, and
what?
Provided.
Oh shit.
Nah, negative.
Now I don't know. I don't have the timetables.
Nah.
I can't say the timetables because I'm gonna give you the rumors, but if I don't know the date, I can't say it.
Nah, that's not. Thick and slick, man. Thick and slick.
Yo, this guy's crazy.
Yo, Castle,
this is what I do
here. This is crazy.
So far, we found out two things, Pucci. Since Pucci my coach, we found out two things right now. Found out that Chance is, he indulged in the groceries.
Gotta eat the booty like groceries. That's Chance's favorite line.
And he also get cars. So that means he's doing.
What?
We found out that Diddy sprain.
Yo, you're crazy, man.
Now, how do you feel about a female that you done fuck? I'm gonna start with you, dude. How do you feel about a female that you done fuck, and then you see her with somebody cuffing?
I laugh, and I laugh at the person. I see that all the time when I'm at certain events, you know, and. It's nothing, but then when you, it's a difference.
Until you put in the phone.
It's a difference. Like, nah, I'm good. It's a difference when you out there, you just kissy, and a lot of people I know touch that, homie. You might want to be careful.
We're not gonna do that. Wait, hold on now.
But it's a, like, you know what I'm saying?
You know I gotta jump into this conversation. Yeah, because you just left the discussion.
I'm just saying, you know?
Alright, so how do you avoid the fight? Like, I mean, you know.
It's no fight.
Nah, but I'm saying, as a promoter, like, no matter what, you're always gonna be promoting to every single person that you know, even if it's not directly, it's indirectly.
Right.
So, how do you avoid people you already got conflict with? Showing up at one of your parties, like how you feel about that?
They coming, I won't say nothing to them.
Yo, Castle, I want you
to. I will.
Diddy, don't answer that. Castle, I want you to never do that again.
What you mean?
When we get somebody at the right place.
Oh, now we going back
when
to
we have giving up the juice, you do not get away from that. You keep going and we keep attacking.
Nah,
that's our job.
Nah, I'm gonna answer your question. If I don't like somebody, that happens all the time. They can come to Woodman, they can come anywhere. I won't say nothing to
Woodman tonight.
But thank you. You know, you don't like me. You paying to come to my event.
Tuesdays.
Thank you. Who you doing on Tuesdays?
We gotta talk about that.
I gotta talk to you about this Tuesday business, man.
Now, Chuck. Talk to me. Chuck, I know you're not gonna prove that phone call right now. Now, Chuck, you're doing Tuesdays at Woodman.
Yeah.
Now, who's the Tuesdays with?
Tuesdays with, I got Lennox.
DJ Lennox?
Yeah, shout out Lennox. Mm. Shout out Tex, Power Circle.
I fuck with Tex, that's my nigga. Tex is my nigga.
And shout out Hot Rod. Mm. Hot Rod jumped on under Lennox. Good bowler.
So how was this opening Tuesday?
Opening Tuesday was good. It was real good. It was good.
Was it Sunday?
It wasn't Sunday. Mm-hmm. I don't think Tuesday is going to be Sunday until... Couple more Tuesdays.
Now,
Sunday is
now you're playing strong. A dirty game.
Why?
You're playing a dirty game. You know, you have you're cool with the people you're doing Sundays with.
Right.
And then you just switched it up and went to a different demographic.
Nah, that's cool. No, that's cool.
Let me explain this whole Tuesday.
Are you bringing Relvin to the?
Let me explain this whole Tuesday wave, and then I'm gonna break it down where everybody can understand it. Tuesday. Sunday was about to get shut down. Sunday was about to get shut down. It was about to get shut down permanently because of the crowd we was bringing out. And you know, everybody was feeling that way. And I was getting calls from everybody at this, everybody here, and was saying that we should move. But what I did, as Stunner Chuck did, was took that negative energy and took it positive and adapted another night for it. You know, to keep Sunday keep going, I talked to the owner. I said, look, how about I try to separate the crowd? Give me another night. Now, that was a smart move because without that move, Sunday would not be here still.
Now, but the people on Sunday.
The people on Sunday
is not as close. No, you're closer with the people on Sundays than you are with the people on Tuesday.
Correct.
How did that situation get up?
Like,
you figure, like, Power Circle, they winning. I'm going to go with Power Circle.
Right. Tex had a strong Tuesday wave that he just finished doing that Prelude. I'm sorry. He had a strong Tuesday wave that he just finished doing, and I reached out to him and he jumped on it. Like it was like bringing LeBron on the team. He had that Tuesday wave. He had a Tuesday wave.
So Tex is LeBron. I mean,
LeBron in Long Island. Yeah. I'm gonna give him
a chance. Do you believe so?
Do
you believe he's the LeBron in Long Island? In the promotion?
He does his thing. Texas,
if he's not LeBron, I didn't ask him to do his thing, because I know my man do his thing. I fucked with Texas.
What you mean, like,
is he the LeBron of Long Island?
Of every, Long Island?
Yeah.
It's not too many Long Island guys. I like Cape Boys, but he does his thing by himself, yeah. I mean, his sports is okay. He got his crib, he got his car.
It was doing no his bad thing. It was,
I mean,
no
bad LeBron, if it's about that, then he doing
Champ,
it.
Champ, do you agree?
Honestly, I don't know anybody else in Long Island, so he's the only person that I know.
Now, Pucci, you, I'm pretty sure you dealt with Long Island promoters.
Yeah.
You know Power Circle.
Yeah.
Do you know Texas, right? Is Texas the LeBron of...
Pass the mic.
I mean, I'm going to say, yeah, I mean, they doing it. I mean, no, other than, like you LeBron said, it's other than, what's his name, Cake Boy, yeah. Cheese? Yeah. Other than, but it's hard to say because, I mean, he kind of got that, what's that, love? Kind of got that on Smash, like, every week. So it's like, you know, it's like a neck and neck thing, if you ask me. Yeah. I feel like I mess with them, you know. I've done parties with them, and they all cool people. They all get money. They all about their money, definitely. But I don't want to say fully like he got it all the way under wraps, because they like neck and neck. If you ask me, that's just me being honest.
Like I said, if he's not LeBron, he's KD. Yo, so Diddy.
Yeah.
It's Power Circle.
Yeah, they doing their thing. It's definitely that. You know what? We're not even going to talk about that. Each and every Sunday we have one man lanes. Shout out to Chuck. You know what I'm saying?
That's smart for business. I actually,
you know what I'm saying,
that you matured.
Yeah.
Over the last time you've been here.
You've
been here, if we should rewind the tapes, the last time you've been here, you was deliberately smashing everything about
You know what? I'm not gonna even go that route, because Chuck is doing business with them.
Okay.
And out of respect.
His facial expressions are crazy.
I don't know. Each and every Sunday we hear Woodman Lanes, that's it. Like, Chuck is doing his thing on Tuesdays.
We're not gonna mess up the Tuesday.
Yeah, I don't know. You know what? It's perfect, because Chuck does Tuesdays, you know. I be home.
Sundays.
And then, like, everybody.
Why you be home?
Because I'm on Sundays. I support Chuck. If Chuck asks me, yo, put it up, promote it for me,
you're putting it up.
Yeah, I'll put it up. Because it's
on Mondays,
because it's
on
Chuck.
Mondays, you're at Clippers.
What? Listen, no. Clippers is still open?
On Monday?
They still do Mondays in Clippers?
I haven't heard. I don't sign no contract. The only week. Listen. They said. Never mind. But listen.
Wait. What? No,
because it was a rumor.
James,
that.
You're holding the contract for Clippers?
No. It was a rumor that, I think Tracy wanted to do business.
Trey.
Yeah, well.
Yeah.
She wanted to do business with Chambers. And I told him, no.
What?